My name is Jeff Cassidy. I graduated from Eureka College in 1986. I played in the basketball program my first 2 years and was able to help Coach Darnell as a student assistant for my final 2 years and was a member of Tau Kappa Epsilon. My first thoughts of Eureka College were, as I look back, the age of it. You know, it's been around a lot of years, and even like the big elms that they have on campus, it gave a sense of stability, maturity, you know, and it's a beautiful campus, albeit small. I like that as well. My brother graduated prior to me coming to Eureka College, so I guess my first experience with Eureka College was in the basketball program as I sat in the stands at the Reagan Center and watched my brother play. And him being my big brother, I just thought he was heads and shoulders above all the other people on the court. Well, I'm sure that that did come from Tom, but I do recall that. You know, I come from a huge family. There's 11 boys and 3 girls in my family. And although Tom got letters from, you know, big Division I schools, one of the only coaches that came to visit our house was Dave Darnell. And Dave Darnell was quite a personality. He made a huge impression on my parents. And they really liked him, and they could tell his heart and his passion for Eureka College and for his program. So they definitely left it open to Tom which place he wanted to go, but they definitely didn't try to steer him from Eureka College because of Coach Darnell. As I look back at my 4 years at Eureka College, as it pertains to the Reagan Complex, definitely the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan, coming to make a speech. I think Time Magazine was sponsoring a Speaker of the Year or Man of the Year, something like that. And Reagan had gotten it, and he got to choose where he wanted to speak, and he chose Eureka College. And for a school that small, and specifically for a guy that comes from a small town of Mendota, Illinois, to have the President of the United States in the same gymnasium as you was just awesome. From when they brought the helicopters in, all the dignitaries that came in, that's a memory that I'll never forget. The other memory, you know, personal to me, is at the Reagan Center, just being, you know, with my teammates, coming out of that classroom as we've prepared to take, you know, the court and do battle, and as we stand outside that hall waiting for the other game to finish, just that energy and that excitement that builds amongst a bunch of young men, I'll never forget that. That's an awesome feeling.
That's a great feeling. I can remember being up there and you'd call out your number. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
And I'd always say double nickel for 55 and drive him up a wall.
That's some of the things that Coach would do is those
Every game.
It didn't matter, because one time, I'm sure early in his career, he'd gotten bit with a technical from, in the book, the wrong number being down. I'm sure that's what it is because I asked him. But every game, he would have to go through that thing personally or he wouldn't be able to sleep at night. Looking back at my my time at Eureka in the mid-80s, the facility seemed, you know, fantastic to me. It had a swimming pool in it. It had, you know, all the classrooms. I was a physical education major as well. So I spent a lot of time in the Reagan Center, and it was plenty fine by my standards. As the years go by, it's hard to maintain, and it's hard to, you know, keep that level of excellence. And I think going forward, what's being done at the Reagan Complex is just going to be a driver, if you will, to keep ahead of the rest of the pack, that Eureka College continues to grow. That's why we've been around for a long time, and that's why we're going to continue to be around for a long time. Is when you reach a level of good, the biggest hurdle to overcome is being good on the way to greatness. And I think this is a huge step for Eureka College to achieve greatness by doing things like this that others, you know, would not and could not, that we're able to do. my brother Tom and I decided to support the Reagan revitalization because to me it's an honor. It's an honor to be affiliated in any way with such a thing at the Reagan Complex as well as Eureka College. But I would be remiss if I didn't say at the heart of it all is Dave Darnell. And that was really the driver for me, and I'm sure for my brother as well. From the first time that I'd met him, as he recruited my brother, as he connected with my family, as he did right by my brother, and then followed through everything with me as well. That tradition of TWW, Together We Win, is something that he really has knitted into the culture at Eureka College, specifically into the sports program. And that is really something that rang true with me when we were approached to become a part of the revitalization. I really did think, this is an honor. This is an honor to be able to hook my wagon to something like this. What I'd really like to see happen is not only the continuation of a great sports program at Eureka College, but indeed even enhancing it more. And what really excites me at the core is knowing my story, to know that other kids that are going to be able to have a big time experience at a small Division III school. And it's life impacting. And the melding that goes on between inner city and country folks and Southern Illinois, everything that comes together with all of the different attributes that each kid brings and having that melded together. And I think that athletics, in my opinion, because that's the road that I've come from, is just a beautiful way for people to start in one way for athletics. But at the end, as I look back 30 years later, I think what my intentions were all good, but the things that have evolved from it, the networking that I've had from it, the close lifelong friendships that I've had, the mentoring that I've received, all of those things are just exponentially more than I ever would have signed off for. And I think that that's a huge part of what I look forward to through this whole endeavor of having other kids impacted in such a way that it's just exponentially magnified. Their children will be better for it, and it's just things that it's exciting. See you at the Reagan.